Hello everyone, my name is Big Head Code, and this is part 2 of the real-world origin of Street Fighter characters. If you haven't yet, please check out part 1 and leave a like or comment if you enjoyed this video. In early sketches, Guile was noted as being created to appeal to Americans. He is a major in the US Air Force and has American flag tattoos on both his arms. He's that damn American. Despite this, his original design was inspired by French character Jean-Pierre Polnareff from the series JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. Although some aspects of this original design remained, Guile's trademark haircut was changed to that of the character Rudolf von Stroheim. The name Guile is also inspired by JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, being based off Polnareff's archenemy, centerfold Jay Guile. The character Dan Hibiki made his debut as a playable character in 1995's Street Fighter Alpha, and he's gone on to appear in a number of different titles. Though he is somewhat of a fan favorite, Dan is often added as a joke character, known for his short-range fireball and his moveset consisting of mostly taunts. But his first appearance in the Street Fighter universe was an illustration by co-designer Akira Yasuda. SNK released their game Art of Fighting 1 year after the release of Street Fighter 2, and the two games featured more than a few similarities, some even calling it a Street Fighter clone. In retaliation, Yasuda drew a picture of Sagat holding what looked like a combination of Art of Fighting's two main characters, Ryu Sakazaki and Robert Garcia. The character wore an orange gi similar to Ryu, and sported a long tail and gloves similar to Robert. Though never intended to be an actual character, this design would later go on to be the inspiration for Dan Hibiki. Though his real-world inspiration is pretty obvious, I can't make a real-world inspiration of Street Fighter characters without including Fei Long. Making his debut in Super Street Fighter 2, Fei Long is a kung fu practitioner as well as a movie star, similar to his real-world inspiration, Bruce Lee. Fei Long sports black pants and shoes much like Bruce Lee's signature look, as well as using nunchucks in his winning animation. In Street Fighter 4, Fei Long even had an alternate costume where he had cuts on his face and body, similar to the ones Bruce Lee had in the film Enter the Dragon. Another character with connections to Bruce Lee is Eagle, who made his debut as an unplayable character in the original Street Fighter. Eagle is an English bouncer that sports a bow tie and suspenders and is often depicted as having a large scar on his face. This look is similar to the bodyguard portrayed by Robert Baker in the film Fist of Fury. Eagle would later become a playable character in the game Capcom vs. SNK 2, where he became an homage to the late singer Freddie Mercury. Eagle's voice dialogue used lines inspired by Mercury such as "No time for losers" and "The show must go on." His win quotes in the Japanese version of the game also made his sexuality ambiguous. The character DJ made his debut in Super Street Fighter 2. He is a Jamaican kickboxer and musician who sports drawstring pants and a braided tail. He is also the only mainline Street Fighter character who was conceived by an American. While working for Capcom USA, designer James Goddard suggested they add a character based on the American kickboxer and Tai Bo creator Billy Blanks. Not only does DJ's face resemble that of Blanks, his trademark haircut is based on Blanks' appearance in the film King of the Kickboxers. Ken made his debut as the second playable character in the original Street Fighter. Ken is an American martial artist who is most commonly seen with blonde hair and his trademark red karate gi. His design is most likely inspired by American martial artist and actor Joe Louis. Louis became famous for his accomplishments in martial arts during the 1960s, winning numerous tournaments and appearing on the cover of a number of martial arts magazines. Not only was Louis blonde and American, he would often sport a red gi similar to the ones worn by Ken. Definitely one of the most mysterious characters in the Street Fighter universe, Q made his debut in Street Fighter 3 Third Strike. He is of unknown origin and conceals his face behind a metallic mask. His appearance is that of a classic detective, sporting a hat and trench coat, as well as a tie and gloves. His design is based off the character K from the 1973 series Robot Detective. Both characters have single letter names and very similar clothing. Q's facial features are also identical to K's, and both characters have yellow eyes. That's all for now, but there are still more Street Fighter characters I have yet to cover. If you like this sort of thing, please consider subscribing and looking out for more videos in the future. My name is Big Head Code, and thank you for watching.